freshmen, Mr. Hicks, Ms. Spencer, faculty, family, friends. Thank you for coming tonight. All the teachers get here. Congratulations, class of 2013. I'm certain I'm speaking for my whole class when I say today is the day we've been waiting for. To put it rather bluntly, freedom and independence. Today marks the time we become our own persons. For the first time, we can genuinely make our own decisions. In fact, we're forced to. What college will I attend? Where will I live? What will I do to earn money? Who will I marry? What do I want to accomplish? What am I going to do? Why do I what I do? What is all this for? What am I for? What do I stand for? What do I stand for? How important is this one decision? With it inevitably comes the questions of what are my beliefs or what are my values, and in the end, who am I? We exemplify nothing other than the sole thing that we choose to portray. You are what you love. In the end, it will decide what we accomplish in life. In this respect, this one decision, what do I stand for, writes our future stories. I guess we have to give a good answer. But is it not sad that the only answer we can give most nights is just a pathetic, I don't know? Most people seem to have found a sort of answer, but the oncoming storm of factors in sociology, such as bullying, homosexuality, feminism, social media, and the rest of the world, have sought to encourage people in their time of grief. When I look through Facebook, Tumblr, and other social media sites for a few minutes, I usually find several inspirational posts or motivational pictures with thousands upon thousands of likes. I've heard songs on the radio telling me not to let others limit my possibilities in life. I can be my own spotlight and do what I alone like to do. Walking through Los Angeles, I spotted phrases spray painted on the sidewalks. You are perfect the way you are. Don't change who you are. You are strong. You are beautiful. I was in Salem filled with admiration for these people who just want to bring a little bit of encouragement into someone's life. High school definitely made me realize I need as much encouragement as I can get. However, how do these messages fare in the full picture of life as a whole? The world is constantly telling us to stand for ourselves. Do the things that you like to do because you like to do them, and that should make it right. It all goes to show the world's worldview, an elevation of self. Society tells us to accomplish goals to glorify ourselves because evidently we're worth it or even good enough. But are we? By standing only for ourselves and our own wants, we're only limiting ourselves to our imperfect characters and our limited visions. We'll get nowhere if we only exemplify temporary themes of life. Worse yet, our lives may run down a backward spiral as heading nowhere because while we may individually be strong, when put up against everything that the world holds, we're weak. If our lives reflect our idols, glorifying ourselves only leaves a life of full glory and empty accomplishments. For all flesh is as grass, and all the glory of man is flower of grass. The grass withereth, and the flower thereof falleth away. 1 Peter 1:24. The world tells us to do great things for society, but we cannot accomplish anything exponentially great if we don't do it for the sake of something equally exponential. If we yearn to live life to its full potential, why should we want to represent anything less than perfect? Life should not be about ourselves because we're fallible. The solution naturally has to point to something much higher than ourselves, something perfect and magnificent and firm enough to stand upon, something just. And here we come to the point where Christians have found some answer, and that's God. And I don't know about you, but my God's perfect. As the name suggests, we as Christians are expected to represent Christ, someone who we claim is righteous beyond flaw. Some of us even zealously proclaim the stance for God with no hesitation. But do we really realize the magnitude of this claim? More and more, it seems that Christianity is just merely following the Ten Commandments or being the world standard of good. But God is his own definition of pure. In fact, it's a pureness that can only rightfully and precisely be described by the term God. That's why we're commanded to not use it in vain. It's holy beyond compare, and we're commanded to portray it in all of its glory. While the world says, be your own definition of you, 1 Peter 1:16 states, be ye holy, for I am holy. If we choose to represent God, we should choose to live by a supernatural standard of perfection, because any other standard, including our own personal ones, would be unacceptable. Of course, we can never possibly reach God's point of righteousness in our current state because our greatest deeds are filthy rags to him. But it only means we should go beyond ourselves, work with an overachieving attitude, If we can accomplish something great, we can accomplish something greater for the good of God's glory, which is shown to the world. The world judges you by the product you produce. Let's produce something worthy of a king, and even beyond that position. With God, our potential should be never-ending. Let us take full advantage of that potential by working and never stopping. Is this endeavor to achieve a higher and higher standard of fuel if we never reach true perfection? 1 Corinthians 15:58 states that we should always be abounding in the work of the Lord, for as much as you know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord. With God as the foundation in our life, we're given the hope of great things promised, and our work is given meaning. Without this hope, we become nothing, and our work that we've done means nothing, because it leads nowhere. Let us give our lives thus far, from childhood to much-awaited adulthood, some sort of worth. Today is the day we make our own decisions for fire, our own answers to the questions of life. What do I stand for? Let's stand for something worth standing for, and exemplify it in all its glory throughout life. Let's choose now and act as we set off and discover what we really yearn to represent and who we really are. I really wish all of you the best, class of 2013. Congratulations, and thank you.